Brainstorming. What you understand by that is storming the brain. Neurological research has told us that the brain learns better in cooperative and collaborative environment. And that's why there are many strategies developed keeping this in mind. And brainstorming is one of that strategy which encourages students to work in cooperative and collaborative environment. Let's see what it is and how to conduct that. Here is a content outline, the nature of brainstorming, definition, characteristics, principles, objectives of using brainstorming, process of conducting brainstorming session, various types of brainstorming, brainstorming techniques. There are many different techniques available and the teacher can select according to her convenience. Equally important is role of a teacher and of course advantages of brainstorming as a strategy. At the end of this session, you will be able to explain brainstorming strategy. You will be able to list principles underlying brainstorming. You will be able to discuss need of using brainstorming in the classroom. Explain process of implementing brainstorming strategy. Elaborate on various techniques of brainstorming strategy and discuss advantages of brainstorming. Let's see what is brainstorming. Brainstorming, the nature of brainstorming, as I said earlier, is collaborative and cooperative. So it gives opportunity for group creativity. It is a group creativity technique. It is designed to generate a large number of ideas to solve any problem. Major thrust is solving a problem by generating many ideas. But there is a focus on one single problem. So all these solutions, ideas are basically for solving that problem. So it is focused on a single topic and it is time bound. We don't continue doing it again for weeks together. So it is time bound, you can decide the time and start conducting it. It breaks the usual thinking pattern because it is not individual thinking, it involves cooperative thinking. Together students think about it and come to certain solutions. Here are some definitions of brainstorming. Brainstorming is using brain to storm any problem. Wonderful definition given by Osborne. If you see a dictionary meaning of brainstorming, it is a conference technique by which a group attempts to find the solution for a problem by amassing all the ideas spontaneously contributed by the members. If you see here, amassing all the ideas, that means there are many ideas which are generated together and it is for solving a problem. And these ideas are also spontaneously contributed. You place a problem before the students and ask them their ideas. So spontaneously they come out with ideas, they contribute ideas, and that is how this brainstorming session is conducted. You see here brainstorming in progress. What is happening here? Students are giving the ideas, someone is writing it on the board, and the board will very shortly get full of these ideas. This is how it would look after your session. After the students have generated various ideas, it would look like this, full of ideas. You can have the slips and they can be stuck on the board or you can write on the board. Let's see characteristics of brainstorming. Students are encouraged to give ideas freely. What is important is this word, free expression of ideas. In a relaxed state of mind, without any inhibition. The neuro research tells us that brain learns better in unrestricted environment where there are no inhibitions. And in this strategy, brainstorming strategy, inhibitions are not there. Students can express their ideas freely. That is the first and foremost characteristic of brainstorming as a strategy. It also gives emphasis on quantity of ideas. In the beginning, we will see that in the beginning, we don't give importance to quality. We just want the students to come out with large number of ideas. So what is important is quantity of ideas. It is also a democratic process because every student in a class gets an opportunity to come out with his or her ideas and contribute to the process of brainstorming. What are the guiding principles underlying brainstorming? Let us see some of these principles. The ideas come when the brain is liberated to function uninhibited in a stormy condition. What are the important words here? Uninhibited. There are no inhibitions, there are no restrictions. The environment is free. Their free expression is encouraged. That is the underlying principle. We should not create any threats. We should not create any restrictions. The problem is posed before the students and students come out with their ideas freely. Students can learn better through interactions because there are a lot of interactions. We will see that. But this is the underlying principle that the students learn better through interactions among themselves. A large number of ideas are generated, but don't think that all ideas are going to be used. From that large chunk, very few ideas which are feasible, which are usable, which may be practical, have to be identified. So that is the next stage. So it's not that the whole chunk of ideas, say 100 to 120 ideas are generated, we are not going to use all 100 ideas. Then the next step would be that we will find out the best ones. So it is a small chunk which is going to be useful, but still we generate large number of ideas. Why we should use brainstorming in a classroom? What is the purpose? What could be the objectives of using brainstorming in our classroom? Let's see that. Basically, we use brainstorming, a collaborative and cooperative strategy, to develop divergent thinking ability in students. Divergent because there is a problem, but that problem can have many solutions. There is not necessarily a solution for that problem. This requires not a convergent thinking, but it requires divergent thinking. We have to think differently. We have to think in different directions. So this strategy develops that kind of thinking, divergent thinking in the students. To elicit as many number of ideas on the theme as possible through collective creative thinking. These are very important terms. This is our objective, that thinking has to be generated, but this is a creative thinking. But this is also a collaborative or collective thinking. One student says some solution, another student builds on that, third student still builds on that, and new ideas keep coming. Here they learn from each other, they use each other's ideas, and there is no inhibition. Nobody is going to say that this idea was already said, but somebody is building on that idea is also encouraged. So many ideas are generated, but they learn from each other in the process. To develop in students an ability to address a problem creatively. In our daily life, we face many problems. Now, for example, how to keep our school or college area clean? Now, this is a problem, a singular problem, and now this problem is given for brainstorming. How to address this problem? Not necessarily only in a traditional manner. Brainstorming encourages that to solve a problem creatively. So it is basically a problem solving technique, but problem solved not in traditional manner, but creatively. We have seen the nature of brainstorming strategy. We have also seen its characteristics and the purpose of using it in a classroom situation. Thank you.